Hello everybody, dear colleagues, friends, interested parties. It's a bit unusual to speak to an audience like that. I'd like to welcome you heartily to this inaugural webinar of our new ISHR cardiovascular webinar series, which is hosted by the International Society for Heart Research and its official journal, the Journal of Molecular and Cellular Cardiology. My name is Thomas Eschenhagen. I'm a pharmacologist from the University of Hamburg, and I'm current president of the ISHR. And I hope you see here this gallery of beautiful people. I start with Tish Murphy on, oh yeah, how do we do that? Yeah, that's Tish Murphy, immediate past president of ISHR International. And Yoshi Saito, he's below. He's a future president-elect of ISHR, and you should imagine that it's 1 o'clock in Japan, so he's heroically attending this first webinar. In the middle of all is Rong Tian, our new editor of the Journal of Molecular Cellular Cardiology, Rong Tian. And on the upper right is our keynote speaker of the day. Many people know him, Eduardo Marban from CEDARS, and he will introduce the secrets of COVID and the heart. And finally, on the left, upper and middle panel are the most important people, Davor Pavlovich and Michael Shetto, because they actually initiated this webinar. So thanks already at this point. So why do we start this webinar series today? Obviously, it's all about COVID, which is for all of us a new and a pretty extreme situation, I think. Seems very different in different countries, but we all are affected heavily. And it's interesting to see that the lab science is differently affected in different countries, from almost normal to more or less complete shutdown. And I think it was on this background that Davo came to this idea. A second reason was that at this point, I think nobody knows how long that crisis will last. So it's probably unrealistic, as some prominent Western leader said, it's going to be finished after Easter. It's probably a bit later. We think it's going to be more May, minimum, or even later. And if you see, for example, China needed only 4 weeks to cope with the crisis, from mid-January to 2 months, actually, from mid-January to mid-March. Europe is shifted by about 4 weeks, and it's probably take much longer. The US is even more shifted a bit to the right. So in any case, all of you know this crisis will keep us in a strange situation for long, and that's the reason why we thought it's good to create something new. So what can we all do? What can every single person do? I think everybody has his own answer to this. I personally think It's of course, it's super important to act responsible and be careful, but also without being panicking. And I think also it's important to somehow continue our normal job, our normal work as much as possible, because otherwise the secondary damage will be enormous. And some of us are actually looking specifically what type of science they can contribute here. And it's amazing to see, for example, in circulation, we are flooded by papers about COVID. JMCC experiences the same thing. There are many, many initiatives worldwide. First data coming out. I know from several groups, for example, the German Center for Cardiovascular Research, that people start looking at systematically what exactly is the influence of ACE inhibitors, ARBs, on ACE2. What do viruses do on, for example, iPS myocytes? Interesting question. Is there really a direct effect? Many people do single cell sequencing to answer the question, which cells in the body, in the heart, express ACE2? And it's very interesting, actually, these first data. Pericytes seem to be full of ACE2. And others try to think about studies. I think, at least in Germany, we decided to participate in the large 5-arm WHO trial and also to do own registries. I think all of these things are important. But Davor and Michael Shattuck had the great idea to introduce this new series of webinars. And the idea here is simply, I think, science goes on. Our own conferences have all been cancelled. Every conference has been cancelled. And so we thought that this may be a welcomed way to still continue scientific exchange and discuss about new things, new ideas, and current work. So the main point here is just to share and discuss science in the cardiovascular field, not about COVID. Today is an exception with Eduardo. I guess it's leaking in every discussion, but it's overall all about our own science. And that's actually the one and only mission of the ISHR. And we want to do this in this really wonderful context of ISHR as an international, truly world-spanning family of scientists. And the good thing in this format is that it's completely open to everybody. So at present, I don't know how many people are watching, but more than 800, I think, applied or registered. It's probably more than most of our conferences gather for one talk. We designed it fully open access, so it's free for everybody. We don't have to travel. We save a lot of costs. We save the negative impact of traveling on the climate. So it even has some positive aspects, as maybe in general this crisis may have some, at least some, positive aspects. We advertised the webinars through our ISHR communication channels, but of course we hope as well to reach out to others and to even more people, and it seems to work. And I think at this point I would just like to thank Davor and Michael for having this great idea, but I also would like to thank Rong Tiang, who immediately said, yes, let's go for it. The rest of the leadership, Tish, Leslie, Yoshi, Lee, Arthur, everybody agreed. So I think it was a nice response. We were pretty quick. So here we are. And now it's up to all of you as volunteers to put it in life, because I mean, it's not the idea that only we as a, let's say, established, a little bit older people talk, but that young people use this as an exchange. And I think it's important actually to imagine at this point 800 people worldwide watch this. So young ones, you will have an enormous exposure here, more than most abstracts. So take the chance and use the space in the list. I think the list is already pretty busy, but I'm sure there are still places to be. It doesn't cost a little preparation, but that's about it. And so I hope that this series will have a life, maybe even a life after COVID, which hopefully is over soon. And before closing, I would just like to use the opportunity that despite webinars and all these beautiful online tools, we still have conferences. Our main congress will be the ISHR International Congress in Berlin. This will be June 12 to 15, 2022. Check the website. But of course, there are also the section meetings. Unfortunately, this year, everything was canceled. The American, the European, I don't know actually about the Japanese, but I heard the Australasian has been canceled. Everything's canceled. But next year, certainly there will be all of these conferences. They're really nice. It's a beautiful place to have also personal exchange. So please consider ISHR. Maybe be a member. And it's everything is living from membership in the respective sections. And so please think about it. And with this, I would like to introduce two speakers. First, tomorrow, just a reminder, the first regular webinar will be given by Manuel Meyer, a proteomics expert from KCL in London. It's going to be certainly very good. He's a super speaker. And now, for the first inaugural webinar, we have the privilege to get Eduardo Marban talking about the secrets of COVID and the heart. And I know that he has given this or similar lecture already in Cedars, and it's been a big success. I think most of you know Professor Marban. He has been not only a very established electrophysiologist and editor of Circulation Research, but over the last 10 years has been very prominent in the stem cell field, cardiospheres, and I think many of us are curious to listen to what you have to say to COVID and the heart, Eduardo. So thank you very much for agreeing to give this talk.